conductor Howard Mitchell, and the National Symphony Orchestra are accepting the plaudits of the audience here in Constitution Hall at the termination of La Fontaine's From Sea to Shining Sea, a work that was commissioned especially for this 1961 inaugural concert. The President-elect and Mrs. Kennedy are seated in their box directly behind us here to the left of the stage. And I must say at this moment that a little scattering of applause you hear is for some more of the musicians who have made their way through this terrible storm of snow that is hampering all traffic and movement through the Washington area. Even as a matter of fact, the printed programs have not arrived due to the fact that the truck carrying them was stalled in this heavy traffic clogging that has been going on since early this afternoon. But more people are coming in now, and there has been a slight change in the program. As I say, we don't have a printed program now, so we are doing this, shall we use the word, ad libitum. As the conductor feels it, he is bringing the concert into being. We are about to hear a work for chorus and orchestra by composer Randall Thompson called The Testament of Freedom. It's a setting of four passages from the writings of Thomas Jefferson for men's voices and the orchestra. And in this case, the men's voices will be that of the male chorus of Georgetown University, Paul Hume directing. They were to be joined in this rendition of The Testament of Freedom by the male chorus of Howard University, Warner Lawson directing. But there too, the buses bringing the members of the Howard University chorus were bogged down in the tremendously heavy snowfall, and they have not been able to make their way to Constitution Hall at the moment. Our conductor, Howard Mitchell, has returned to the podium and is receiving the plaudits of the audience. Once again, he bows.
Nature, as you see, has a way of thwarting the best plans. Our Howard University choir has not arrived.
To the audience.
Mr. Elmont has not arrived. So we will perform next The Testament of Freedom with the Georgetown University Men's Glee Club.
He now turns back to his orchestra and the chorus of Georgetown University, and we hear The Testament of Freedom by Randall Thompson.